In this video, we'll be reviewing the Schneider Easy9 Compact Consumer Unit. Schneider produce a couple of consumer units under the Easy9 banner. There's the Easy9 Plus, which we featured as part of our EV charger install series of videos, and then there's the Easy9 Compact, which is what we'll be looking at in this video. Now, it's been named Compact as it's designed to go into smaller spaces where traditional boards may not quite fit. But with so many consumer unit options on the market, it's fair to ask the question, what sets this one apart from the others? Well, for me, it's flexibility. There's a couple of things in here that make this consumer unit really flexible and adaptable to whatever installation you're working in. You can get this consumer unit preloaded with the main switch and other devices pre-installed. However, it also comes as just the unit by itself, which you can then put together yourself. Now, it's a bit like having a blank canvas to work with, if you will. Now, that may just sound like more work. However, you'll start to see the benefits when we look at the main switch here. If you look at it closely, you'll notice that it doesn't have any markings on it for the terminals for which one is line and which one is neutral. And that's because you can install the main switch at either end of the consumer unit, giving you loads of flexibility when it comes to bringing your tails in, especially helpful if you're doing a consumer unit replacement, as you can change the board to suit the existing cabling and then place your buzz bar as required, either treating the left-hand pole as the line connection or the right-hand one if the main switch is at the other end. Clever stuff. So that's one feature that adds to the flexibility of this consumer unit. But what about the devices that go in here? There's a bit of a debate raging at the moment as to whether dual RCD boards are compliant or if all consumer units should just contain RCBOs for the circuits that require RCD protection. Well, it's a good question, and we've made a comprehensive answer to this in a free accredited CPD module on circuit protection that we've made in association with Schneider. So click the link below to have a look at that, and to find out if split load boards are still compliant with BS7671. But Schneider have really neatly straddled the line with this consumer unit by making it appropriate for either format. If you look at the neutral bar at the top here, you can see it's made up of three separate bars that are joined together with these U-shaped links between them. So with the configuration we've got here, the consumer unit is set up and ready to be used as an all RCBO board. And you'll notice that these RCBOs are all type A, rather than AC, which is good as they can keep doing their job even when up to 6 milliamps of pulse DC current is being leaked back into the system by various loads in a property. However, if you'd rather set it up as a dual RCD board, then you can remove one of the links and take a neutral tail out to each RCCB and then cut the buzz bar down and you're good to go. You can go one step further by removing two of the links and creating a split load dual RCD board with a section having no RCD protection if needed for loads like the supply to an EV charger or something like that. Just while we're looking at those neutral bars, we'll take in the earth bar as well, and you can see there that the terminals are a really generous size and will accommodate the largest of cables that you're likely to find in this kind of application. In addition to these features, you can see that there's loads of options around the outside here with a variety of easily knocked out blanks in 20, 25 and 32 mil, along with 32 mil knockouts on the sides for bringing tails in if required. So we've seen the flexibility and adaptability of this unit, but there's also some interesting points to be considered for the installation surrounding the DIN rail. Now, compared with other consumer units, this DIN rail has been dropped down, creating additional wiring space at the top of the unit where it's really needed, as well as allowing more room for the extra height of the RCBOs to be installed. The DIN rail has also been brought forward, thus giving you more space to wire behind, and it can really easily be removed, meaning you can dress and route your cables with it out of the way completely before you pop it back in to connect up. Critically, it's also got this central support in the middle of the enclosure that really helps to keep the DIN rail rigid and prevent it from bending, sagging, and resulting in device droop. We said at the outset that this board is called the Compact, and it's designed with smaller installation spaces in mind. And that philosophy extends to little things like the front cover, where there's this little molded indent, making it easier to open the lid up and access the breakers, even if this is installed in a smaller space. Of course, any modern consumer unit needs to take account of the fact that our distribution systems are seeing increasing network transients, or surges as we tend to call them. And these aren't just caused by lightning, but are far more likely in most properties to be caused by switching surges. The 18th edition of BS7671 saw an increased requirement for the use of SPDs, and this is likely to become even more stringent in the second amendment. The new Easy9 Compact consumer unit caters for this because there is a simple SPD kit available that comes with all the bits you need to simply add surge protection to your installation. It maintains the flexibility of this consumer unit by allowing you to select and configure the system to the installation needs. So, how does the Easy9 Compact consumer unit from Schneider stand out from the crowd? By being compact, flexible, and easily installed, that's how. But as always, we want to hear from you. Have you had any experience installing the Easy9 Compact or the Easy9 Plus? What other features did you spot along the way that we've missed? Or what would you like to see in your perfect consumer unit? Please leave your thoughts and questions in the comments below. And as always, thank you very much for watching.